Hi everyone, my name is Berthe and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing something quite different than I would normally do. And I am creating some characters from The Lion King as I imagine them as Sims. So, The Lion King, the remake of the Disney movie, is going to be released today in America. I have looked that up, which I find a bit strange because it is being released on the 17th in the Netherlands, and usually, like with any other movie I've ever known about, it's first release in the US and then in the Netherlands. So this is kind of different, and I don't know why they chose to do it that way, but I'm sure there's a reason for it. Anyhow, I'm going to see the movie somewhere next week, so I'm very excited for that. Yeah, so let's talk about this movie. The Lion King is my favorite Disney movie, and I remember watching it like all the time when I was at my grandparents' place. They had it on VHS and I would continuously watch it together with Harry Potter 1 and 2, by the way, which in Dutch, as a kid you don't notice, but when you watch a VHS in Dutch and everything is synchronized, it's terrible, especially the Harry Potter ones. But we're talking about The Lion King. It was and is my favorite Disney movie ever. I was never really a kid that liked the princesses and the cute and sweet kind of movies. I was more about the animals. I was and am a big animal lover. I wanted to be a vet, like a wildlife vet and stuff. But yeah, I liked movies with animals and well, The Lion King has animals, so yay. Other movies that I really like Disney movies, are Brother Bear. I liked that one as a kid and I still like it. I also like The Little Mermaid, not because of the mermaid, but because of all the fish. I know it sounds weird, but yeah. And I also somewhat liked Snow White and Cinderella. Again, not because of the princesses, but because of the animals in the woods in Snow White and the mice in Cinderella. I know I'm a bit crazy when it comes to that, but I just loved and still love animals and anything to do with it. And yeah, Lion King is also set in Africa, which is one of my favorite places in the world. I visited Africa, South Africa, twice now. I came back in December from a two-month trip in South Africa, where I also volunteered in a game reserve for a month, which was literally the best thing I have ever done. Being so close with the animals, observing them and helping them directly, like helping preserve their habitat directly, it was one of the most amazing things I've done. But yeah, I love The Lion King, I love Africa and everything to do with it. So for these Sims, I didn't restrict myself. I just, for example, this is Nala, and I don't know if she looks anything like the movie Nala, but I just let my imagination do its thing and I came up with this. I had a very particular way that I wanted her to look, so it took me a long time to finish Nala. I've been using many skin details to get her to look the way I wanted her to look. But I'm very happy with how she turned out. I tried with her clothing to get some African influences in there. I hope I did justice. And what did I want to say? I wanted to say something else, but I forgot. Yeah, I wanted her to look a bit playful because I see her as a playful lioness, and but also very strong-willed. And I gave her the ambitious, genius, and romantic trait. I just, for some reason, found those the most fitting for her. And she also has the Strangerville mystery kind of aspiration, because when everything is going down, you know, with Scar being the new king and everything is crumbling down, she is the one who's going into the woods, like over the borders of the land, to try and find a solution, try and find game to eat, and she ends up finding Simba. She is the strong girl who goes to find out what's going on and how to solve it and stuff like that. So that's why I gave her those traits. Also, I don't know if you guys seen it, but I love The Lion King musical. I've seen it, I believe, yeah, four times. I've seen it four times. Once, when I was about 11 years old, I think. It was excuse me. It was my very first musical ever. I know my mom took me there, and yeah, my first musical ever. And if you've seen it, you know what I'm talking about. But in the beginning, the opening scene when the music starts and all the animals come out, it's just, it left such a big impression on me. I cry every time I hear the music. I'm not kidding. Yeah, so that's the thing. And then the musical stopped performing in the Netherlands, and it came back, I think, 4 years ago already. They decided to bring the musical back, and I was so thrilled. So I went to see it with my boyfriend. He's not a big musical fan. He liked it, but he wasn't a big fan or anything. Then I brought a friend of mine who said she hated musicals, but she had never seen one. So I was like, girl, you gotta come with me and see this. And she loved it just as much as I did. Then the last time I saw it was actually only a month, 2 months ago, I think. My mom got to buy very good tickets for a very cheap price from a colleague from her, because the colleague couldn't go. And so we were able to go, and it was the last time I saw the musical, because now it has stopped. And that makes me very sad, knowing that I don't have the opportunity to go whenever I want to see it. But I hope that they will bring it back again in like 10 years or something, because I would just love for it to come back. I don't know, I'm very sentimental, and I just love it. I'm very passionate about Africa and animals and the Lion King, so yeah. You know, I want to see the musical. And is it still playing in London? Any of you from England who know if it's still playing in London? I would love to see it there in English, because obviously I've seen it in Dutch. But I think seeing it in English would be really great as well. Yeah, the music is great. I don't know what they did in the English version of the musical, but for the Dutch version, they kept like the same songs, but they did change the lyrics ever so slightly, so that it's not like an exact copy of the film, which I really appreciate. It's really well done. And there are some, like as I said before, there are some songs that I have to cry when I hear them. It's crazy, I know, but that's who I am. And also the music from the original movie, by the way. I love them a lot. I love Just Can't Wait to Be King. And He Lives in You from the second movie, I think, is beautiful as well. Also in other languages. I love learning languages. And listening to Disney music in other languages really helps me, because I am a person who learns from listening instead of reading. And, you know, Disney music, you know what it's about because you've heard them in your own language or in English, and, you know, you get the lyrics, you understand what it's about, you have visuals that go with them. And then when you listen to them in other languages, it's very easy, well, not very easy, it's easier to make sense of the words than it is when you don't know what the song is about. So I used to listen as a kid to a lot, still, by the way. When I'm learning a language, I still listen to Disney music. But also when I was a kid, I used to listen to Disney music in all kinds of languages. And I loved it. I loved trying to understand songs in other languages. For example, I listened to Hakuna Matata in Danish. I don't know anything about Danish, but I loved trying to make sense of the song. Am I weird for doing that? I don't know. I still like doing it. For example, when I was learning Portuguese, like a year ago, I would say. Yeah, a year ago. I would listen to music, Disney music in Portuguese and Brazilian Portuguese. And it really helped me to get, you know, the pronunciation right, because you're trying to sing along, and it just helps. It helps me, at least. Have you guys ever been to Disneyland? Because I have been, and I want to gush about it. I have been to Disneyland Paris a few times, and I absolutely love it. If you like, what do you call them, theme parks, if you like theme parks, Disneyland is amazing. They have many different kind of attractions and stuff, and the roller coasters generally are great. I am like the, what do you call it, adrenaline seeker. So every roller coaster and other things that go really fast, really high, are my thing. So yeah, I love Disney because there's a lot of Disney, of course, and I just love Disney. And my favorite attraction in Disneyland Paris, I think, is the Tower of Terror. It's just, I love the atmosphere and the thrill that it gives you. Another thing that I like was the Rock'n'Roller Coaster, because it's so fast. But I believe they are changing that up and changing it into another attraction. I'm not sure if it's even going to be another roller coaster. So that makes me somewhat sad, but you know, you can't have everything. When I was thinking about this, I just realized there's no Lion King attraction. Why is there no Lion King attraction? Okay, to be honest, I don't have any clue about how I would design Lion King attraction. Would it be like the Peter Pan, like a slow ride for the kids, or would it be something more thrilling? I don't know, but I think it would be cool. You know, you could have super awesome effects with fire when, well, not with fire. Yeah, with fire at the end when Simba is trying to defeat Scar and everything is burning, and it would look cool, I think. But yeah, this summer, like this July and August in Disneyland Paris, there's this Jungle Book and Lion King theme thing going on. And I really wanted to go there, but it's very expensive. And my boyfriend doesn't want to pay so much money to go there for just, you know, a few days. And I don't know anyone else to come with me, which I think is super sad. And yeah, that's it. I'm super sad. I just really wish I could go. The Jungle Book is also one of my favorite Disney movies. I think maybe if this video ends up being well received, I might do the Jungle Book characters as Sims as well, like have Baloo and Bagheera. Is that what the panther is called in English? I must say I have only seen the Jungle Book, like the original one, in Dutch. I just realized. I haven't seen the English version. It's Bagheera, right? I am just not sure right now. But yeah, to imagine those as Sims as well, I think that would be cool. So yeah, maybe I will do that in the future. Let me know if you'd be interested in more of those Disney character reimagination Sim videos, if that makes sense. Okay, let me know, guys. What do you think about all the Disney remakes that are coming out, have come out recently, and are coming out soon? Because there are people like me who love everything about it, but there are also people who are like, oh my god, why the heck would you make remakes, like make something original and stuff like that, which I also understand. So what are your thoughts about it? I personally think it's great. I love Disney, and I also love animation movies that look more realistic, like the Jungle Book remake that came out a few years ago. It's amazing. I love it. I haven't seen Aladdin yet. Aladdin? I don't know how to pronounce that in English. But I haven't seen that one yet. And I also haven't seen Dumbo, even though I'm super excited to see Dumbo. It's not in theaters anymore, though, so I don't know how I can see it. If you've seen it, let me know what you think. I think Disney combined with Tim Burton in the Dumbo movie, it seems like a really good combination. Like, it's going to be so interesting, I think. But if you've seen it, let me know what you think. And the Aladdin movie, I'm not sure if I want to see it. I do want to see it, but I have never had a thing for the Aladdin movie. I think I saw it once or twice, and it wasn't my thing. I don't know why, but it just wasn't. Any other Disney remakes that I'm forgetting about? The Little Mermaid is coming, right? Yeah, there was this whole thing about the actress being dark-skinned, and I'm like, who the hell cares what kind of skin color she has? I think she looks and sounds perfect for the role of Ariel, if you ask me. I think people should stop being so sensitive and open up their minds to new interpretations of the story and just enjoy the new movie for what it's going to be. It's not going to be an exact replica of the old movie, and I don't think it should be. Oh well. I think that is going to be an amazing remake. I would love to see it in theaters when it comes out. We're getting to the end of the video, so I'm gonna wrap it up about here. I hope you liked watching this video. I think Timon and Pumbaa are based on the original characters the most. Like, I tried to give Timon the white face that he has, and I gave Pumbaa the high cheekbones, and I gave him, they're not here yet, but I gave him earrings to imitate tusks, if that makes sense. And he has a wide upward nose. I don't know the name for it, but you get what I mean. And his hair is like the hair that he has in the movie. And I think, even though I wasn't sure if I liked the sim, I think I did a good job, like, putting the character into the sim, also for Timon. I really liked how the sim turned out in the end. So I really hope you like them too. I will be putting them on the gallery if you want to. And I will try to get to link all the CC on my Tumblr, which you can also find in the description. The link to my Tumblr is in the description. So yeah, I think that's it for now. Let me know if you enjoyed this video, because I am thinking of also doing Scar, Zazu and Rafiki, you know, the other characters, but it takes a long time, so let me know if you'd be interested. Thank you all for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!